This means adding fractions by adding the denominators together and the numerators together. What are the natural numbers A, B, C, and D that satisfy this equation? Have you ever tried adding fractions like this before? It kind of seems like it could work, doesn't it? But if you solved it this way, the answer would be wrong. Let's take an example. A half plus a half. The actual sum is 1. However, if you add the denominators together and the numerators together, you get 2 over 4, which is a half. The left-hand side and the right-hand side don't match. Try other fractions. Probably you'll get the same result. Could there be a pair of very special fractions that satisfy this relation? The challenge is to find those special fractions. The only given condition is that A, B, C, and D are natural numbers. First, add the fractions on the left-hand side. The result is BC plus AD over AC. To eliminate the denominators, multiply both sides by AC. Then multiply both sides by A plus C. Expand the equation. Remove the same terms from both sides. This is the final equation. Now, all that is left is to find A, B, C, and D that satisfy this equation. But here's the thing. Since A, B, C, and D are natural numbers, both b times c squared and a squared times d are greater than 0. But this equation says that the sum of two positive numbers must also equal to 0. Is that even possible? No, it's not. This equation is always greater than 0. So there are no a, b, c, and d that satisfy this equation. In conclusion, you can't add two fractions by simply adding the denominators and numerators together. Even if you don't like it, you have to find a common denominator to add fractions properly. What happens if A, B, C, and D are integers instead of natural numbers? The conditions have changed. Will the solutions change as well?